If you are someone that regularly goes to gym, then you can skip this video. But hey, you can share it with someone who doesn't. I am making this video because someone asked me, what is muscle? I don't want any muscle. One of the common things that bodybuilders hear from people is, I don't want to be like you. This Arnold meme is super famous because the truth is, it is hard to build muscle and you don't become Arnold by chance. Memes apart, not just bodybuilders, even someone as lame as me gets to hear things like, I don't want muscles. Why should I build muscles? I don't want to look like you. I don't want abs. I just want to lose belly fat, side fat, and so on. First, spot reduction is not possible. Second, some people think muscles are alien. Like, I don't want all that. I wear clothes, so I don't care what is underneath. I just want to look lean in clothes. Point is, even if you don't want, we all have muscles. Three different kinds of muscles in all of us. Skeletal, smooth, and cardiac muscle. So you want it or not, all of this exists. Skeletal muscles are responsible for all your movements and actions. Smooth muscles are what line your vital organs. And cardiac muscle is what your heart is made of. So what do you think will happen if we lose all muscles? We die. Doctors prescribe steroids to preserve muscles when people suffer from muscle wasting diseases like cancer or HIV. Remember the understanding hormones video? I mentioned that our body works on homeostasis. Everything is interconnected. Muscles are connected with nutrition, rest, strength, hormones, everything. When you lose muscles, your BMR drops, your activity levels drop. So you can't enjoy food anymore like you used to. If you even eat a little more than you used to, you start gaining weight. Imagine how much we all used to eat when young and watch how much your parents or old people are eating. On top of this, body composition changes when you start losing muscle. You start accumulating more fat. Your hormonal balance changes. Overall, when you lose muscle, you start having a poor quality of life. But are we losing muscles? Why should we be worried? We are just gaining weight, right? So muscles are also increasing? No. Research has shown after 30, we all start losing muscles slowly. This age-related muscle loss is called sarcopenia. This is natural. But what happens is much more than natural. Most of us in our generation are super stressed. Even buying a house is getting increasingly difficult. Our jobs are getting more and more stressful and paying less and less relative to inflation. I don't think humans have been under such continuous stress anytime in our evolutionary history. And stress produces the hormone cortisol, which is highly catabolic, leading to increased muscle loss than otherwise natural. On top of this, our nutrition is poor. All our diets lack nutrients, vitamins, and minerals, and Indian diets are really deficient in protein too. How can we expect not to lose muscle then? Again, it's not like we are losing kgs of muscle every day or every time we get stressed or don't eat. It just has an impact on catabolic processes and accelerates muscle loss a bit. So now we have established we experience muscle loss due to age, stress, poor nutrition, etc. So how to prevent this? This is where resistance training or lifting weights help. It plays a huge role in preventing this muscle loss. It builds and strengthens muscles by a process called hypertrophy. When you lift weights, you apply force, and this leads to microscopic tears on your muscle fibers. Your body has to work and repair it, and in this process, your body builds your muscles stronger than before. This does not stop muscular atrophy. There is always a breakdown of muscle proteins, just like we discussed so far. What happens is the body builds more muscles. People think like, now the body uses only proteins. Now it uses only fats. Reduce insulin to start fat synthesis. Or we need to eat protein immediately after workout to start muscle building. Body doesn't work like that. All processes are simultaneously happening. Body uses both fat and glycogen for energy simultaneously. Similarly, there is both breakdown and building processes happening simultaneously. The final output depends on what happens more. There is degeneration of muscle because of natural and stress-based catabolic processes, and along with it, there is regeneration because you lift weights. Also, lifting weights alone may not help. You can never outwork a bad diet. So protein, water, and other nutrients also play a role. Then the question comes, can't cardio alone help you build? Can't I just walk and build muscle? It's not like cardio will not build muscle at all. Cardio is also an exercise. When you run, you use your muscles. Cycling is also shown to activate a lot of muscles in your body. It should help you build muscles, right? And when you don't want to build huge muscles, it should be more than enough. The answer is yes and no. There are two parameters here. The intensity of your cardio and your nutrition. Low intensity cardio and being on a calorie deficit for a long time is not ideal to prevent muscle loss, let alone regenerate more than you degenerate. If someone that's already fit, eating adequate protein and calories and being consistent, then cardio can let you go on without losing a lot of muscle. But if you are someone with a very high body fat percentage, can't do cardio with good intensity, and are in a calorie deficit for a considerable amount of time, then cardio is not the best way to build or preserve muscle. Also, when you get used to cardio, you cannot progressively overload and your body adapts. So between lifting weights and cardio, obviously lifting weights is the better way to build or preserve muscle. Think about it and look out for my next video on how to build muscle. Thanks.